The new FM 101.9. And if you've been listening since we signed on the air Friday, you've heard that song quite a bit. It is Angels from David Byrne. And David Byrne is our first very special guest in the studio. Welcome.
Am I really the first guest in the studio?
You are our first.
Gee.
The first of the whole radio station. We are a brand new baby radio station.
That's pretty good.
Well, thank you for joining us and thank you for kicking it off for us.
Thank you. Thank you. It's good to be. It's the station sounds good.
Well, thank you. That means a lot coming from you. You're in town doing a bunch of dates. You've already done one at the Coach House. You are tonight at the Wilshire Bell Theater.
Mm-hmm.
And then you return to the Coach House Friday night.
Indeed. Right? I think that one's already sold out, though.
That's what I heard, but there are still some tickets available tonight.
Uh-huh.
And in fact, we've got some we're going to give away a little later on. And your new record, David Byrne. This is the first one you've called by your name.
Yeah, because it's kind of, a lot of it's kind of about me, from me.
Very personal.
Sort of.
Yeah. You know, I was going to say it's kind of a back to basics. It's a four-piece band.
Uh-huh. It's kind of stripped down sounding.
Sounds real good. In fact, you're going to play something from that record for us later on, but you're ready to do a Talking Head song, I understand.
Yeah, sort of. I haven't done this in a while. I did it, I think, on the last... Yeah, I know I did it on the last tour, but I haven't done it recently, and I thought, oh, let's see how it sounds. Okay.
Stand like an Adam and an Eve. Waterfalls, the Garden of Eden. Two fools in love, so beautiful and strong. Birds in the trees are smiling upon them. From the age of the dinosaurs, cars will run on gasoline. Where have they gone now? There's nothing but flowers. This was a factory, now there are mountains and rivers. You got it, you got it. We caught a rattlesnake, now we got something for dinner. You got it, you got it. And this was a shopping mall, now it's all covered with flowers. You got it, you got it. If this is paradise, I wish I had a lawnmower. You got it, you got it. Years ago, I was an angry young man. I'd pretend that I was a billboard standing tall by the side of the road. I fell in love with a beautiful highway. This used to be real estate, now it's only fields and trees. Where is the town now? There's nothing but flowers. Once there were parking lots, now it's a peaceful oasis. You got it, you got it. This was a Pizza Hut, now it's all covered with daisies. You got it, you got it. I miss the honky-tonks, Dairy Queens and 7-Elevens. You got it, you got it. And as things fell apart, nobody paid much attention. You got it, you got it. Cherry pies, candy bars, and chocolate chip cookies. You got it, you got it. We used to microwave, now we just eat nuts and berries. You got it, you got it. This was a discount store, now it's turned into a cornfield. You got it, you got it. Don't leave me standing here, I can't get used to this lifestyle.
Wow. David Byrne. Hey. Yes. Applause coming from the main studio and our live studio here at the new FM 101.9. David Byrne is our very first special guest. I've heard you do that song with a big band behind you probably many times. I've seen you perform it. But this is the first time I think I've ever seen you do it just you and a guitar. And I recently read somewhere that you did some live acoustic dates with Lucinda Williams, Roseanne Cash, and Natalie Merchant.
Not all at the same time, although Lucinda and Roseanne and I did a radio show once. Yeah.
Are there any recordings of that anywhere, of any of those performances?
Yeah, there are. There are some.
Any chance we may get you doing some acoustic dates out here on the West Coast? I know you live in New York.
Maybe when the tour with this band is over. But we're doing performance we're doing is acoustic.
Oh, really?
About the first 30, 35 minutes or so. It's the band kind of play hand percussion and
do
all that.
Tell us about the band. There are four of you on stage.
Uh-huh. There's myself and a guy named Todd Turkisher on drums, Paul Soklo on bass, and a guy named Mauro Refosco on mallet instruments, vibes, marimbas, and percussion.
Wow, I can't wait. I'm going to go to the show tonight. You know, we gave away some tickets. I think I gave away 5 pairs of tickets yesterday for the show last night at the Coach House, and 3 other people called today to say it was just amazing.
Oh, incredible. That's good to hear.
So they had a great time, and we're looking forward to this tonight. You do a lot of new music.
Yeah, we do a lot of new stuff. It's not really that we're trying to plug a record. It's that we're really having a good time playing it. We're doing a lot of old stuff, too,
mm-hmm.
and we're doing a few songs that we learned that we haven't recorded, or some of them we recorded and haven't been released.
You know, I got a fax from a listener whose birthday is today and wants to go to the show tonight. I think we'll give him a pair of tickets. But he said, on your last swing through town at the Wiltern Theater, you performed an amazing cover of Sympathy for the Devil that gave me shivers. This is from Chuck Warner. He asks, how do you pick the covers, which you do on your live show, and do you care to comment on covers included in the current show?
How do I pick covers? It's usually a song. It's got to be a song you like, all right? And I guess it's got to be something where you think you can put a new twist on it.
Hmm.
There's no sense in doing it if just trying to imitate the sounds and do an imitation of the original.
Copy, right.
Carbon copy of the original. The idea would be to put a twist on it and give it a slightly new meaning by musically changing it. And
sure. Do any covers in this show?
Some nights we've been doing a song by, co-wrote it, I think, a woman named Crystal Waters. Hmm. It's called Gypsy Woman, She's Homeless. It was a kind of a disco hit a few years ago. We do that occasionally.
Okay. You've done so much. I mean, in addition to all your albums, which are out there for everyone to see, you've done movies from Stop Making Sense to True Stories to a documentary about a religion in Brazil.
Mm-hmm.
What got you interested in film?
I kind of started off in the visual arts, and when I was younger in school, I used to draw and paint and
take pictures,
do all kinds of stuff like that. At the same time that I was playing blasting the records and playing guitar and doing that kind of stuff, so they kind of went hand in hand. It's kind of like staring at album covers and that kind of thing.
Great. You know, we want to play a song off the new record. The album's called David Byrne. It is new in the stores. What would you like us to play? Any requests?
Lilies, maybe?
Okay. Lilies? Lilies. Yeah, that's got a good thumbs up. Okay, this is Lilies from David Byrne on the new FM 101.9. Lily's the name of the song from David Byrne's brand new self-titled CD on the new FM 101.9. We are Southern California's album alternative. And David Byrne is our very special first guest in our new music studio. And David, thank you for being here today. We were just talking during the song about your other label. You've got a label that you founded back in 1988 called Lawaka Bop.
Yeah, I didn't know it'd been that long ago, I guess.
Yeah,
we started off kind of as a world music label, doing compilations of things that were already existing that were maybe difficult to get. And now we've kind of learned how to make records and covers and stuff like that, and we've branched out to actual living, breathing artists. There's a group called Zap Mama that's been on the road now, and Gegita from around here, the Southland, as you call it.
Coming from someone who spend most of their time on the East Coast, yeah, this is the Southland.
And they're a duo from around here. And
oh wow, because I thought this label it's a lot of different cultural influences. I know you have one Cuba classic. Silvio Rodriguez is the first Cuban album released in the U.S. since 1961 is on this label.
Yeah,
you bring in a lot of other outside influences, outside sounds from.
Yeah, but we don't want to exclude the U.S. of A.
The natives.
Yeah.
Cool. Well, Zap Mama, I just found out, is going to be on tour. They're going to play at Pepperdine here in Malibu on the 8th of September. So we do have a chance to check them out.
They're really good.
Yeah, I read somewhere a label, and I don't like labels, and I know you sure don't, but Pancultural Groove, they assigned that to your music, that's evident and from your records pretty much starting on Remain in Light and moving forward.
Yeah, it is. Well, I have a pretty wide range of listening habits, and it kind of, some of it rubs off.
Yeah, definitely. Well, your whole Brazilian, once you got in a Brazilian groove, I know it turned me on to a lot of Brazilian music that I hadn't heard before.
Oh, great.
Why don't we hear something? You're prepared to do one more live for us, right? Do you want to do that now?
Sure,
cool.
Sure.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to do a song called My Love Is You that I think I wrote the words I was walking in a field.
Okay.
It sounds like a commercial. Some men desire a princess, and others lust for a temptress. Well, I don't need one of those, 'cause my love is you. My love is you. Some men replace their mamas, and some want to young by well, I got no use for those, 'cause my love is you. Love is you. Sometimes, dear, you tell me I'm an asshole. Sometimes you're an asshole too. Even though we're filled with imperfections, I don't think any less of you. I'm primitive and selfish. I'm childlike and I'm helpless. Well, I got that way because of my love for you. My love is you. My love is you.
Yeah. All right. Thank you. David Byrne. Thank that song you. Can be found in its studio version, of course, on the record David Byrne, but that's performed live for us here in the FM 101.9 studios. I love it. I can't wait to see the show tonight at the Wilshire Bell Theater. Got a fax from who is a Scott in Fountain Valley. He says, your musical styles seem to be as diversified as the subject matter which make up your lyrics. In keeping your music fresh, how important is it for you to travel versus just staying in one area or part of the country?
I like to travel. I just love it. I mean, I love seeing other, getting as much as I can a feel of other people's attitudes, other people's the way they live, what they like, their music, their food, that kind of stuff. But I don't know if it's necessary
for your music. But
for creativity or writing or whatever. I think you can, you can kind of travel in your head, and somebody doesn't have to. Whatever, a lot of detective writers were never detectives.
Sure.
And yet they write a real good detective story.
Just have a great imagination.
Yeah, you just have to. It can all happen in your head.
Yeah, I always thought you were from Baltimore. And when I knew I was going to have a chance to talk to you, I did a little bit of research and found out you were born in Scotland.
Yeah, but I did grow up in Baltimore.
Right. But lately you've traveled back to Scotland quite a bit and traveled along the countryside.
Yeah, I've been back there a few times. It's a really great place. It's not as depressed as it mm-hmm. was before. They used to have be known for shipbuilding, and not so much anymore.
There's a new band out of, well, they're not so new, but a band out of Scotland that's finally getting some airplay here called Texas.
Uh-huh.
That you'd never know were from Scotland by listening to them, especially by the name of the band. You live in New York City now.
Yes.
And I understand that you have a passion for Citroën cars.
Oh, I have one out here.
Do
that
you?
It spends quite a bit of time in the shop.
So those cars break down and people are still like, do you have one in New York?
No, I don't have a car in New York. No, I take a taxi or ride a bicycle or whatever.
That's smart. I lived in New York for a while, and you're better off not driving. You recently had a photo exhibit in New York.
At CBGB's. They have, well, not at the club, but they have a gallery kind of coffee shop next door.
Mm-hmm.
The CBGB's mall.
Right.
I showed photos there. I'm showing some in Europe, and they're traveling around, that kind of thing.
Any chance of bringing them out here? I feel like we're left out. We're all the way out here on the West Coast.
Yeah, sure. If somebody, asks, I'm much more than willing to put the show together.
You hear that, galleries? Uh-huh. David Byrne will put a show together for us.
But it seemed appropriate I had talked to some galleries in New York, and it's another world. But it seemed kind of appropriate to start at CBGB's, where I started musically.
Absolutely, and CBGB's just had a big celebration, and you returned there.
Uh-huh.
How was that?
Same as it ever was.
Uh-huh.
It was
classic line.
Yeah, and to their credit, they haven't improved the place.
Uh-huh.
And it really, I mean, somebody else would have ripped everything apart, and it would have never been the same. And they've kind of it hasn't fallen apart,
right.
But they haven't
fixed it up much either.
They haven't fixed it up.
All right, how about if we do another song of David Byrne's brand new album called David Byrne? One of my favorites is Buck Naked.
Oh, thanks.
Why don't we do that one on the new FM 101.9? That's David Byrne, Buck Naked, from the CD entitled David Byrne. I love that song.
Thanks.
Did you write that for your daughter?
Sort of, yeah. Yes, sort of. My wife's sister passed away from AIDS-related illnesses, and my daughter was, our daughter, was very much aware of that process. And I didn't consciously write the song for her, but, during those moments, I just started singing this song to her, and it kind of, I guess I was, explaining it to both of us, mm-hmm. what was going on.
Yeah, I think it works on a couple of different levels. If it's just on the surface, you're taking it and buck naked, and it's kind of a...
Yeah, and of course, she just loved a song with the word naked in it.
Of course, and it's fun. But it also, to me, I got a feeling of honest and innocence, like innocence of birth and going back to basics, and that's kind of what this album is all about.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so I thought that might be a cool way to wrap up the interview. And thank you so much for coming in. This has been a real pleasure for me. I've been a fan of yours for many, many years.
Thank you.
And I've seen you perform, and it's the first time I've met you. And what a way to kick off our live music studio here in our brand new radio station. It is great. And David Byrne will be appearing tonight at the Wilshire Ebell Theater. There are still some tickets available, not very many, but there are some, so get on down there. I'm going to be there enjoying the show tonight.
And I heard it's a nice place.
It really is. You know, a friend
place
of mine.
I haven't played before.
A friend of mine got married there recently, and it's beautiful. 8 o'clock show.
Okay.
All right, we're going to give away some tickets. So the numbers are. You know what? I'll do it in a couple of minutes because I don't have the numbers in front of me. We're going to go out with a song from Zet Mama, which is one of the bands on your label, Luwaka Bop.
Oh yeah, I think what's queued up is a song where they do a James Brown a cappella thing.
Oh great! All right, David Byrne, thank you so much. This is the new FM 101.9 Southern California's album Alternative.